Our project itself was to map in very high detail an abandoned marble quarry at Wombeyan Caves for the National Parks and Wildlife Service. And so we contacted CSIRO that had this amazing device called a Zebedee, which is a handheld device. You just hold it in your hand, and as you walk along, it wobbles, and there's a laser which scans back and forward at 40,000 times a second. And as it wobbles about, it basically effectively looks around the cave and takes thousands and thousands of measurements. And so after you just wander around the tracks in the cave for a few hours, you've scanned the entire cave. The reason why we like to scan caves and find this information out is, on the scientific side, there's still a lot of research going into how caves actually form. And so looking at the cave structure, it's called the geomorphology of the cave, and looking at the shape of the cave, we can get a bit of a clue as to how the cave might be formed. We've discovered quite a few things by looking at the data in the data arena. When we look at Wombeyan cave data, we can look at the roof and the sides of the cave, and you can see stream channels in the roof, which means it was formed by water moving through that cave system. And also looking at the cave in 3D and considering the geology, we can look at the cave and think, now where else are there going to be undiscovered passages? Where would this cave continue on? The reason why the data arena is so special is that it's got that ability to show you visually really, really complex data sets. And sometimes when a data set's in tabular form or just data or in spreadsheets, you can't really see what's going on. If you can visualize the data, the brain is one of the most fantastic computer devices we have, but it's very visually orientated. And if you can then see a little pattern visually, then you can go back to a high performance computer and you can say, this is the pattern I'm looking for, find other patterns like that.